Hello there, and welcome back to Hallownest Vocalized. In the first episode, I actually started straight with the poem. But in this one, I wanted to actually show you guys this amazing little menu screen. Alongside this awesome OST. I recently actually, before starting this video, I listened to it entirely and it's amazing. Anyways, I also have one more surprise for you all once we get in game, and I think you might actually know what that might be since I finally have mods installed. And that is, drumroll please, we're playing the prequel to Silksong! Well, actually, kind of literally. Anyway, yes, I downloaded my first ever skin, and I know, stereotypically, it is the Hornet skin. I just barely got it. I know that it changes charms and stuff, or at least some of the charms, I believe. Not entirely sure, but yeah, we'll see. Anyway, what are we doing today? Well, in theme with the Hornet skin, today is going to be getting through to Green Path. Most likely I'll do Fungal Wastes as well, because Green Path actually doesn't have that many characters with voice that talk. But yeah, we'll see where we get. Realistically enough, the first character that we can meet is either the Hunter or Zote, depending on which way we go. And I think I'll really, like, keep this series more of a mini-series, if you will, where I just go to and talk to the different NPCs and just give out my opinion to the voice acting, which until this point... Oh, Silk. Throwing out Silk, that's cute. Until this point, the voice acting's been amazing. And the reception to the first episode of Hallownest Vocalized was also amazing, and I want to thank you all for the views and the likes. Oh, and down in the acid we go. An amazing start to the video. Yeah. Well, I think I'll actually see you guys. Of course, if there's any other random voice lines that might just appear. Oh, there's also some of the lore tablets that will also have voice acting, which is really interesting. Oh, I don't know why I thought there would be something there. Anyway, I'll see you guys when the first voice appears. Well, more like it's heard, but anyways, see you guys then. Hello, other me. How's it going? Aww. Like, you see yourself from, like, I don't know, 10 years ago? I don't actually know how long the timeline of Hollow Knight is. You just run away. You're not even, like, interested. Honestly, it would have been interesting if modders could take this even further beyond and just change the story depending if you have the Hornet skin. That would be funny. I actually want to try something out here. See if it actually... Nah. I would need to get a lot of practice in there. Yeah, no, I was quite certain that I wouldn't be able to do it like on the first try. I still wanted to give it, you know, a good old beginning try. Anyway.
Isn't this a contrast from the crossroads? Such a humid, lively place. The roads twist and turn in the most wonderful ways. I've done my best to chart the area ahead, though I must admit, some of the area's inhabitants proved quite a nuisance. I I ran into another traveler as I made my way down here. I tried to call out to her as she dashed past, but she barely even glanced in my direction. Not an appreciator of maps like you and I, obviously. I ran into another traveler as I made my way down here.
Okay. Anyway, it may make sense. It's talking about hornets, you know. Cornifer. Yeah, I was wrong. Entirely wrong. Cornifer is actually the first one you'll meet here. Oh, hello. Oh, Grubby. Let's just so get him. Kinda sad that there's no, like, grub voice. Actually, there is! But we need a dream nail. Now, I won't leave this guy here, but, after we get the dream nail, that's gonna be awesome. See what the grubbies are, what the grubby voice is. Ah, I can't wait. It's just like 30 seconds away from. Yeah, good morning to you too. Oh, I need to approach him.
Tiny Squeeb, you approach fearless. Are you a hunter like me?
Oh, I love this one.
Do you feel the urge inside to stalk, to kill, to understand? Then take it, my journal. He'll aid you. At first, the text may seem difficult to discern, but a learned hunter will come to understand its words. Venture the depths of this land and slay its beasts. Prove yourself worthy to bear the mark of hunter.
Actually, I think I'm getting even more excited. If it's gonna be how I think it's going to be first.
Little Squib, you may have overcome a few creatures, but you are only just beginning. Don't delay. Descend into the belly of this world and hunt down the life you find. Little, don't
okay. Okay. Journal. No?
Timid scavenger that crawls through the caverns looking for food. Timid scavenger that crawls... Simple-minded creature that haphazardly buzzes around.
Okay, do we have anyone that's unlocked?
A maggot driven mad by a strange force. Inhabits a stolen armored shell.
No, we don't get the second.
A maggot driven mad by a strange force. Inhabits a stolen armored shell.
Aw, that's so sad. So it seems like the hunter notes from the journal. So when you completely, when you either defeat the boss or you completely get one creature, like fully researched, you get the hunter's notes, which just give you even more information, but from like the perspective of the hunter. Oh, come on. It's just that it seems like those aren't voiced. Which is really unfortunate, in my opinion. That would have been a really nice place to add voice lines. Then again, I would think that doing the hunter voice kind of like... screws with your throat in general. At least it sounds like it would. Hello, Hornet! You know, I'm not too sure. Should I bring up the S word? Hello. I'm not entirely sure. Would she, like, ignore me even more than she does now?
Those who stray from the White King's roads shall face the Law of Un.
I don't wonder if this was a random person chosen for that, or if it's it's supposed to be a character. By random person, I mean a random voice actor that doesn't voice a character already, or if that's supposed to be the voice of a character in the world.
The greater mind once dreamed of Leaf and cast these caverns so. In every bush and every vine, the mind of Un reveals itself to us.
I actually really like the casting choice for this one. There's no real discernible, like, who should voice Lord Tabas, because there's stones. Oh, come on, I wanted to get the lifeblood in here. Hello. Time to do... I'm not gonna say what. But yeah. Anyways, the voice casting is really good there. You get silked. He got silked! What can I say? Well, now here is a moral dilemma. Do we save Zoat or do we leave him here? Well, it's a moral dilemma because Zoat is very annoying in general. So, I'd much rather leave him here to die. But, weirdly enough, this is the first time I ever want to listen to his 57 precepts. So, yeah, let's save him. We need to listen to those precepts. Come on. There we go. God, I'm tempted to do something very dumb. And that is to actually put out a video with Zoat reciting all 57 precepts. We'll see, we'll see. That's still ways off. Good day to you, sir.
Just what do you think you're doing? You dare to come between me and my prey? Is it a habit of yours to scurry about, getting in the way and causing bother?
I already hate him. And just to tell you guys one thing, if you begin to hate the character because the actor is playing them so well that it makes you hate them, they've done a good job.
Know this, Kerr. I am Zoat the Mighty, a knight of great renown. Cross me again, and you'll find out why they call my weapon. Life Ender.
Yeah?
What are you still bothering me for? I'm a knight. I'm not interested in your childish games. I need my rest. Be gone! Lest I draw my nail.
Would you attack a child? Because currently, I'm baby.
What are you?
Oh, that's it? Oh man. Anyways, with Zoat saved, it is time to go towards victory. And hearing the 57 precepts of Zoat. That as well. Oh, hello. Oh my god, she's so cute looking at the map. I do want to see one, actually. I do want to see the sleeping animation. Oh god, that's expensive. I have money, but that's still expensive. And while we'll wait for the sleeping animation, I actually want to call the stag. I actually totally forgot about the stag stations. Those are also voiced. Come on, Hornet, fall asleep for me. That sounds creepy. Aw, that's cute. Hello. Oh. What? Really?
My. This place is much changed since I last saw it. The greenery grows so wild. The stations like to be consumed by it. Eager to travel?
Then again, it's only like one voice line. But it's time for the main attraction. Haha, well, at least of this part. That is... Miss Hornet. I'm excited. can't wait to hear the voice actor for her. Hello.
Come no closer, ghost. I've seen you creeping through the undergrowth, stalking me.
Is that an accent? Interesting.
This old kingdom. A terrible thing awakens. I can smell it in the air. I know what you are. I know what you tried to do. I can't allow it.
I do still like it. Still pretty good. Ouch. You know, she's attacking me almost as if I asked when's Silksong coming out.
Too weak, little ghost.
Are you sure about that? Imagine BMing in the middle of the a fight. Get silked on, bruh. Oh god, she almost silked me.
No shadow will haunt me.
I do wonder one thing. Are these voice lines only like on all bosses, or is it only on bosses that usually you don't have the
only pity for your cursed kind?
For the characters you that you find that you usually cannot fight with the Dreamnail, because normally there's no way for you. Well, there's some ways to get Dreamnail pretty early. Not sure if before Hornet. Anyway. We got the cloak! Let's go! If you would look sideways at Hornet right now, it looks like a face. Okay, that's weird. That's funny. Come on, talk to me! Ah, the Dreamers. I forgot about the Dreamers, too. Do I need to try to leave, or...? There we go.
What did it seek to break the seal?
They cannot be undone.
They must be undone.
Oh, that's so perfect! Because the thing is, it's somewhat obvious, especially after you see that there's three of them. Like, it's obvious once they spawn in that there's three entities talking, but generally it's kind of weird when it comes to that, and realizing that there's three people talking at the same time. Anyway, we have Dash, oh my god, the one thing I like to spam, and I almost fell into acid multiple times. Anyway, let's talk to Krull. Hello, Quirrell. How's it going?
Oh, hello there. Seems we both tread far from the path. I can hardly believe those dusty old highways led to such a lush and lively place. This building suggests some form of worship, though its idol has clearly been long forgotten. Doubles equally well for a moment's respite. I saw a strange fellow out there. He seemed quite taken by the lake. I'd planned to offer greetings, though figured I'd first tend to my nail on chance our meeting goes poorly. Your nail looks a fine instrument, but it's showing signs of wear. I'd wager up there it would take you far. Down here, however, I suspect you'll soon meet dangers the surface world can't match. Hallow Nest is perfect for vigilant explorers like us. So tense and thrilling. In this place, you're either alert or you're dead. Hallow Nest is...
You know, you think that them seeing a random child approaching, they'll be more concerned about their safety. Anyways. Hey dude, how's it going? Okay, not the talkative sort either. Anyways, I think that's it for Green Path. I don't believe there's anyone else remaining when it comes to voiced characters. Of course, going back and talking to some characters to get new dialogue. Well, actually, no, I'm lying. There's a Nail Master, but unfortunately, he's unreachable until we get the Crystal Dash, I believe. Either Crystal Dash or Claw, one of or the other. So, yeah, there is one more character that we could talk to. And while I'm trying to get all of them, there will be some I might miss either because I forget about them or we can't get to them right now and I forget later about them. Kind of like how I almost forgot about the Nail Master. And who knows, in the future I might forget about them again. So, that's that. But yeah. So now, it's onwards towards the fungal wastes. Let's go. We have one more coral voice lines there. And we have Willow. Which I'm really curious about the voice actor for Willow. Ah, Millabelle.
Hello there, dearie. I was just about to close up shop and run till you came along. I provide a banking service if you're interested.
You mean run with all the geo you got from unsuspecting fools? Yeah, I know you. I know your tricks.
Losing one's geo is a terrible thing, and it's so much more likely if you carry it about on yourself. My vault is much more secure. In all my time as a banker, I've never lost a single geo. Maybe you'd considered opening an account?
No, thank you.
I understand. It's difficult to part with hard-won geo. I'll be here if you change your mind.
I almost died for most of this geo, so no thank you. Liking the voice, not gonna lie. Again, up until this point, nothing really seems too weird or out of place. Well, Quirrell, I've seen you 5 minutes ago. It's time to talk with you again.
Isn't this something? I'd not expected to discover so huge a stag station after that foggy descent. The bugs of Hallownest must have been an impressive lot, building such grand structures so far into these wilds. Seems the dangerous creatures about haven't yet made their way in here. It's the perfect place for a quick rest. Can you imagine this place in its time? Hordes of bugs traveling about the kingdom, stag bells ringing, the station bustling with activity and life. Now only our like even know it exists. That's a special thing, I suppose, to cherish these sights, even in their decay. Is it that, just faintly, you can still hear the echo of the bells? Is it that?
And I think this is Willow.
Oh, come and fetch a treat, have you? I chanced upon a unique little fungus growing right above us. I found it only in this station, and the taste is just divine.
Has an air of creepiness to her.
This place must once have been quite the hub, built at the border between two lands. That misty drop to one side, and those bulbous growths another.
Oh my god, the little, like, eating thing.
Neither place seems particularly welcoming. So while my little treats last, I think I'll stay right here. Feel free to stop by any time. Though I do like the quiet in this station. A little company is always good for one's health.
Indeed. Though, to be honest, with the voice having this little creepiness factor, it kind of gives more credentials to the theory that she's like, you know, eating the bug that's up there. But then again, this isn't official or canon, so... Still. Because there's a bug corpse up where Willow is eating her trees that says, if you dream nail it, it says, please don't eat me, or something like that. And it gives off the vibe that Willow is eating bugs. But I don't think so. I think it's just the bug not wanting to get eaten alongside the treats and stuff. Anyways. Come on. Come faster. Thank you.
You've opened several stag stations now, haven't you? I'm thankful for the opportunity to once more travel through the kingdom. As I visit more places, I feel my memories returning to me. Like the stagways of my mind are running once more. Continue to open the stations, and you'll have my deepest gratitude.
Sir, yes, sir.
Ah, this gladdens me. The Queen's Station is opened once more. This place was a bustling hub of travel. Well placed for travelers visiting the outer edges of the land. You're quite the explorer to find this place. Eager to travel the stagways?
Oh, okay. Actually, I want to finish to end this episode now that we're here, but first, since there's more voice lines back at I don't think I've talked with Sly. Once he got to the shop, so let's go talk with Sly. And give Elderbug a listen.
Oh, what a turn! Our shopkeep's come home. Just wandered back in. I'd hoped for grand tales of his time below, but he seems to remember almost nothing. Maybe it was all too much for him? If you're interested in his wares, watch out. He drives a hard bargain, that one. No competition. That's the problem. It's bad for the market. Not that he's complaining.
Elderbug over here with knowledge of the market.
I never thought I'd see such a thing. This stag station has opened. That building lay silent since before even my time. Oh, I've heard the tales of the glorious lines. A web of tunnels running all through the kingdom. Not that I'll be traveling them, mind you. I'm quite content where I am. Did you visit that temple? A strange building, I've heard. Though I'd never dare the journey myself. The braver among us once went there to pray. Said they felt at peace within the walls. After a while, they stopped going. I wonder what changed.
Maybe the infection that is seeping from within the Black Egg Temple. At least that's my guess. And Sly, hello.
Ah, hello. I knew we'd meet again. How do you like my cozy little store? I've made myself pretty comfortable here, selling old trinkets to travelers like yourself. If you're planning a trip below, I've several items that may improve your chance of survival.
Patamas, Gio. I didn't want to buy...
Do you find yourself leaving a lot of Gio? This old thing? Merely a fragment of something larger. Still, maybe you can make some use of it. A piece of a soul vessel. You know, those ghastly-looking orb things? I don't really like the aura about it. But it's quite rare, so I'll have to charge you a high price.
High price, yeah, sure, totally. Anyways. Well, I think I'm going to finish this episode here. The series will continue with hopefully daily uploads. I will try to do so. Getting through the game, at least the main areas that lead up to the normal ending. I'll see about going further, and I'll put the original Hollow Knight series that I was doing on break for now. Anyway, yeah. So next time we'll go through the fungal wastes, and since I believe the fungal waste doesn't have that many characters, well, I'll also continue into the City of Tears. Also depends on what time I have, because unfortunately I also have work. And yeah, I do have time to record during the lunch break and after work, but yeah. Anyway. So, I want to thank you guys for watching, and if you've enjoyed this video, please leave a like, subscribe, or leave a comment, and I'll see you in the next one.